There are times where you'll want multiple properties to use identical expressions or an external data set. This is where the eval method and JSON can save you loads of copy and pasting. The eval method reads each line of text from a text layer as JavaScript source code instead of plain text. It's useful for creating a master expression to link multiple properties to. In this composition, you'll see a number of star layers. You'll also notice an eval expression text layer visible in the composition. Let's link the opacity of the star layers to the text layer's contents, which will drive the expression. So come down to star 1 and hit T on your keyboard to open opacity, and then add a new expression. Then come up to the eval text layer and rapidly tap UU to reveal the source text property. Now you can come back to star 1, click into the existing expression, and start this with the eval method, eval, open parenthesis. Now grab the expression pick whip and come up to source text and let go. Now the last thing we have to add to this reference is period operator value. And this is going to evaluate the original text layer's contents. And then close parenthesis. This line of code is referencing the eval text layer. It's looking at the source text property and it's grabbing the value, which is a text string, and then evaluating it as JavaScript code. So now if you click out of the expression, it's going to error out, and that's because eval expression is not valid JavaScript. Now you might be thinking, why isn't the expression down here? It shouldn't matter what's up here. But this text layer is now live JavaScript code. So if I double click this to edit the contents and just type 1, you'll notice that the error went away for the expression, and now the opacity down here is set to 1. Now if I just add a 0, the opacity is set to 10. Pretty cool, right? This is linked dynamically. But you can get pretty complex with this. Because this is live JavaScript code, you can do something like value, and now it's evaluating 25%, which is the original opacity. And then you can add an addition operator, and then 25. And so now it's taken the original 25% and added 25 to it, and opacity is evaluating at 50%. So let's do something fun with this. I'm gonna add a wiggle expression, open parenthesis. I'm just gonna use 5 for the frequency, comma, 25 for the amplitude, and close parenthesis. So you noticed as soon as I finished the expression, the error down here went away, and now the opacity is going to start wiggling. So this is pretty cool. This text layer is serving as the actual expression for this opacity property. Now you can right-click opacity and copy expression only, and then select star 2 through 12 and paste. And now if I hit T just to see these values, you'll see that they're all wiggling using these parameters. Now the coolest part about this is how you can change the values here to affect all the layers at once. So if I change the frequency to 50, you'll see that some of them updated. And now the wiggle effect is much faster because it's using 50 on every single layer. So if I select this and delete the contents, and then target a layer using manually typed quotations, you'll see what happens. So you can probably already tell how these quotations are slightly slanted when they're normally straight up and down. And that's going to cause a problem with this effect. So even though this is valid syntax, because these quotations are not correct, it's giving us an error for each of the star layers. So there's two ways to quickly fix this. One of them is to open up a expression window, type a quotation, copy it, and then you can remove the expression, and then come in and paste it. And now it's substituted the curly quotes with the straight quotes. The other way is to open a text editor of your choice and do the same. Type a quotation, copy one of them, come back to After Effects, and paste it. And now that I've fixed both of these quotations, it is properly referencing the planet's transform opacity. So just keep this in mind when you're using this method. The evalFile method can read an external file and is very useful for workflows. This method is similar to the eval method earlier in this lesson. It just reads a local text file on the computer instead of text layers in the project. So in order to try this technique, you'll need a text file with a properly formatted expression inside of it. You can open a code editor of your choice to create the text file. I'm using Sublime Text. On the first line, you can begin an expression as if it were in the After Effects expression window. You can start with something like linear, open parenthesis, time as the source, comma, 0, comma, 2, comma, 0, comma, 100. So this simple expression is going to animate from 0 to 100 across the first 2 seconds of time. So now that you've got your expression created, you can just save this as a text file. I'm going to save it right here, expression.txt. And before you save this, make note of where you're saving this file because you're going to need this path structure later. So now I'm going to save and then come back to After Effects. And now we can actually create the eval file method. So I'm going to go to the planet layer. I'm going to open scale and I'm going to add a new expression. Now on the first line of the expression, you want to specify the file path. So I'm going to create a variable, my path, capital P, followed by an equal sign and an open double quotation. If you're on Windows, you're going to want to start with the drive letter. So forward slash drive letter, forward slash. And then I know my next folder is users folder. So users forward slash. And then I know that my profile name is Animoplex. So I'm going to type Animoplex and then another forward slash. And I know that inside of here, it was located in the downloads folder. So downloads, another forward slash. Inside of that, it was a resources folder. Add another forward slash. And finally, the name of the file was expression.txt. Now, once I have this file path set, I can just add a closing double quotation and a semicolon. Now, if you're on a Mac and you have multiple drives, you may need to substitute the drive letter with the drive name. But in most cases, if you just have one hard drive, you'll just remove that and start with the users folder. Now you can go to the next line. Now, because this is a three-dimensional property, but my expression didn't account for that, I'm going to add the eval file method to another variable so that I can duplicate it 3 times. So I'm just going to create a variable, val for value, follow that with an equal sign. Now I can begin the eval file method with a dollar sign. The dollar object in JavaScript enables evalFile to load an external JavaScript file from disk, evaluate it, and then return the result of the evaluated code. So after the dollar sign, add a period operator, and now we can start the evalFile method, capital F, followed by an open parenthesis, and then a reference to mypath. So mypath, capital P, close parenthesis, and semicolon. And finally, on the last line, I can create a three-dimensional array. Open square bracket, val, comma, val, comma, val, close square bracket. So the first line is specifying the path for the expression text file. The second line uses a dollar object in JavaScript to evaluate the external file specified in the mypath variable. The third line takes the result of that evaluation and puts it into a three-dimensional array. And so now if you click away from the expression, the planet disappears, and that's because its scale is at 0. And if you go back to look at our expression, it's just linear, time, and then from 0 to 2 seconds, it scales from 0 to 100. So I can come back to After Effects and go to second one, and it's at 50% because it's halfway between 0 and 2. If I scrub to 2 seconds, it should be right at 100. And so now if you preview the scene, you have a nice scale-up animation across 2 seconds. You can also go back to the expression and change the value and just simply save the document and come back to After Effects and preview the scene, and now it scales up to 200%. If you've ever worked with infographics or interactive data in After Effects or on the web, you'll appreciate the robust functionality of JSON data files. This feature is only available in After Effects CC 18 or later. If you have a sharp eye, you'll notice that I'm using CC 18 where the previous lessons had CC 17. JSON, or JavaScript Object Notation, is a human-readable structured data format. Using a JSON file, you can store a large amount of data outside of the After Effects project file, allowing scripts and software to process and update the data without touching After Effects. This is an example of the basic JSON data structure. The file consists of key and value pairs. The keys are wrapped in double quotes, followed by a colon, and then a value, ending with a comma. Curly brackets are used to wrap these pairs to create objects, which can be nested to create more complex structures. Let's take a look at how to import JSON data into the composition. If you're inside of After Effects CC 18 or later, you'll notice that inside the assets folder, there's an example JSON file. Now I can right-click this in the project panel and reveal in Explorer. This is going to take me to my resources folder and highlight the JSON file. So if I double-click this, it's going to open up with Sublime Text, but you can use a code editor of your choice. Inside this file, you'll find a number of data objects for each of the planets in the solar system. For this example, we'll look at the Earth object, more specifically, the radius, key, and value pair. Now we can use this data within After Effects to change a property's value. Now the first step for working in JSON is to make sure it's in the project panel. I already have this imported, but I'm going to go ahead and delete it and re-import. Now it imports like any other footage item, so I can hit Control or Command I to import, and I can select it here in the resources folder, and then hit import. Now for this example, we don't even need to drag it into the composition, but you can if you like. Next, you'll need to add an expression to the property that you want to affect. So in this case, let's affect the planet's scale. So I'm going to come down to the planet layer and highlight it, and I'm going to hit S to reveal the scale property and remove the existing expression. Now I'm going to rapidly tap UU, which brings up the edited properties, and I'm going to find the planet path size property, and I'm going to add a new expression. So my goal here is to link the size property here on the planet to the JSON file, and more specifically, the Earth object's radius value. So to do that, I'm going to come back to After Effects, click into the expression, and I'm going to create a variable on the first line called myData. myData, capital D, and then follow that with an equal sign. And now we're going to reference the JSON file. So I can come to the expression pickwhip and drag it directly into the project panel and let go on the example JSON file. It's going to automatically populate this with footage, example JSON file dot JSON. Now after this reference, we need one more attribute to get into the data, and that's going to start with a period operator, source, data with a capital D. Now this is the end of the first line, so I'm going to end it with a semicolon and then move to the next line. And this line is just going to access the Earth's radius. So I'm going to start with my data, which is going to reference the JSON file's source data. After this, I'm going to add a period operator. And at this point, it's important to know the structure of your JSON. So if I open up my file, I can see a series of nested objects. So the first object is planet, and then inside of that is a bunch of nested planet objects. But I need to start with planet because that's the highest item in this object tree. So if I come back to After Effects and add planet and then add another period operator, now I'm ready to access the next object. I'm going to come back to my source data and I know that I want the Earth object next because that's inside of planet. So I'm going to come back and reference Earth after the planet object and then add another period operator and come back one last time. And now I need to reference the radius object, which is going to give me the final value. So if I come back to After Effects and just type in radius. Now there's one last thing I need to do here. Because this is a two-dimensional array, I need to take the radius output and apply it to both the X and the Y dimension. So the easiest way to do this is to just create a variable. I'm going to call it val for value and then equal sign. Come to the very end of the line, add a semicolon, and then go to the third line and begin a new array with an open square bracket followed by val, comma, val, close square bracket. And now if you click away from the expression, it's going to create this huge planet in the center because it's accessing the radius value, which is 6,378.1. So if you come back to After Effects, of course, our scale is 6,378.1. Now there's a few ways you can manipulate this data. I'm just going to come to the very end of val and divide this entire value by 10. And this is going to give us a much nicer value that's very similar to what we started with. Now the cool thing about JSON is it's all live. So right now the value is 6,378.1 divided by 10, which gives us 637. And if I come back to the JSON file and change this to something like 4,000, and remove the decimal. Now if I save this JSON file, Control S, it's going to automatically update without me even reloading the JSON. And this is because it's dynamically linked to this file. We've arrived at the end of lesson 405. linking expressions to external text and JSON files. If you enjoy this expressions course, consider purchasing the paid content. It includes in-depth documentation, extra tutorial content, high-definition videos, and all the project files used in the training. Your purchase will help to create more free courses like this in the future.